Manila and Beijing expand access to a hotline that's meant to defuse conflicts in the West Philippine Sea. But two experts believe this emergency hotline is pointless. Michael Delizo has tonight's top story.
The Philippines and China agree on a new hotline mechanism that offers more avenues for both sides to manage their maritime row in disputed waters. The hotline opens a communication channel between the top diplomats of both parties and representatives designated by the two countries' presidents. This arrangement was the result of the 9th Philippine-China Bilateral Consultation Mechanism held early this month. The talks were held to dial down tensions in the West Philippine Sea after China's violent response to a June 17 Philippine resupply mission in Ayungin Shoal. That incident left a Filipino naval personnel injured and Philippine boats damaged. But maritime rights advocate retired Associate Justice Antonio Carpio believes the new mechanism is useless. Carpio pointed out that the two sides previously established a hotline, but Beijing rarely takes Manila's call.
Called them up on several incidents, they did not answer. So they will answer only at the time of their choosing. So it's useless.
An international relations analyst also believes the hotline will have little effect in defusing tensions.
We need a hotline to communicate to China because, of course, you have an incident, an unintended incident that happened in the South China Sea. Like the actions of the Chinese Coast Guard, the maritime militia, and, of course, the People's Liberation Army is actually being directed from Beijing. Mm-hmm. So what's the point of a hotline? If actually what's happening is, of course, and what I would call a coordinated, very sophisticated maritime expansion.
While Manila looks for peaceful ways to resolve its conflict with Beijing, lawmakers move to strengthen the country's territorial rights. This comes after the Bicameral Conference Committee approved the proposed Maritime Zones Bill, which defines the extent of Philippine waters.
Maliwanag yung karapatan natin kung saan yung ating boundary. Maliwanag yun na may batas tayo na kung saan tayo pwedeng maglayag, pwedeng mangisda. Tapos babalik na rin sa usapan, but may nakapark na Chinese Coast Guard sa Lubang, Mindoro. So maliliwanag to hanggang saan yung boundary.
For a maritime law expert, the proposed law is a way to implement the 2016 arbitral ruling.
With the Maritime Zone Act, then the parameters for the Philippines coming to any agreement with China or any other nation, no, will have been already clarified.
And as both sides work to defuse tensions, China's biggest Coast Guard ship is still loitering in Scottish Shoal, which is well within the Philippines' exclusive economic zone. The so-called monster ship has dropped anchor about 600 yards from the Philippines' BRP Teresa Magbanua. The Chinese ship, which arrived on July 3rd, has ignored calls questioning its presence in the area.
As of 7:30 in the morning, the last image that I got from our Coast Guard personnel from 9701, the China Coast Guard monster ship remains to be inside the Escoda Shoal. It never departed and still anchored there.
Meantime, the Philippine Coast Guard has also deployed the patrol ship BRP Melchora Aquino to closely monitor another Chinese ship that passed near Lubang Island in Occidental Mindoro in recent days. As of Wednesday morning, the Chinese ship is sailing toward El Nido, Palawan. The Chinese vessel refused to signify its intention in Philippine waters. The Chinese ship passed near Lubang Island as the PCG and U.S. Coast Guard were holding passing exercise or PASEX, which includes simulation of various scenarios such as search and rescue and medical evacuation. Michael Delizo, ABS-CBN News.